Got the ThruNite Archer 2A V3 for review today, and I let you know right up front, these are not from the factory. These are marks that I put on it. I was determined that this bezel was going to come off. I thought I had it protected, but I didn't. It's got a nice little AR lens in there, orange peel reflector. It is a screw-in lens. It's got the XPL V6 down in there. The little board's got some screws holding it down. And it is a copper board, if you can see the edge of it in there where the wire slot is. It is a copper board. I don't know if it is direct thermal path or not. But you can see in them thread there, that red Loctite still in there. That's why these things don't come apart easy. But the anodizing was pretty near perfect before I got a hold of it. The knurling is good on it. It's a good grippy knurling on this thing. The clip is reversible. It moves to here and points the other way. I would personally like to see that clip up here where you could carry it head down and get more of the light in your pocket, but that's just my personal preference. This thing does have a momentary on. It's a half press on the tail switch for momentary on, a full click turns the light on, and then the side button, you got low, medium, high, and then you got your moonlight in there. It's a nice low moonlight, and I don't think I took a picture, but there's your beam profile on it. If I didn't take a picture, at least you can see it there. It does have strobe also. Strobe is a long press on the side switch and a quick press to get back out of it. And like I say, it does have mode memory. That's low. You turn the light off, turn it back on, and it's going to come on in low. Reverse polarity protection. Doesn't hit the modes there. Momentary on, all that stuff. It did come with spare O-rings and a lanyard, all that stuff with it. And I don't think I can tell you a whole lot more. It's a well-constructed little light. I'm going to see if I can get it apart more later instead of just there. It looks like it'll come loose here. And you probably can't see it in the camera because I have to have good light. But right in here where this tube is kind of over this one, it looks like that's threaded and then maybe Loctite it in right there. It looks like if you could get that off, then the tail cap would screw down right here to run with a single cell, just like the, I think it's the 1A Archer 1A that has single cell. But anyhow, this one runs on the 2AA's or the 2NIMH. It does not take the 14500, but it does have good output for the 2AA. I'll be doing some beam shots and a outside video here shortly. And really, I guess that's about all I can tell you about the light at the moment. And I'll cover the rest of it in the rest of the review. And I will be back shortly.
Okay, got the Archer 2AV3 down here. Gonna get a little bit of footage out here and see what's going on with it. Of course, as usual, JJ's down here to help me. Checking things out, I guess, make sure everything's all right. Right now, 15 yards from the gate. It's on high mode. That's on low mode. And that's on medium mode. And then your moonlight or firefly, I'm probably 18, 20 inches in front of the camera there with my hand. And I also brought some other lights down here for comparison. Those of you that have the PF04, won't call any brand names, but for those of y'all that have the PF04, you know what it looks like, what it does. That's the PF04 on high, and that's the Archer. PF04 Archer. And I also brought a TG06. Again, we won't call any brand names, but brought it down here also. Get it on high mode here. That's the TG06 on high mode. And there's the Archer. TG06, which I might mention, I've got a NIMH in it also. Just to show what it does with the same kind of cells that the Archer has in it. And there's the Archer again. I'm going to back up here to about 25 yards. Of course, JJ's going to sit there and watch me. He knows when I'm going home and stuff. I guess he thinks I'm leaving. I've got too far. But JJ's my flashlight helper. Never seen a cat that likes flashlights, but he does, I guess. And there's 25 yards from the gate there. Good little old all-around light, real floody beam on it. But all-purpose light, it's really good. Puts out a ton of light for a small light. Back up in this tree a little bit here. I might mention also, we got a lot of mist in the air tonight. I don't know how much it's showing, but it's there definitely. That tree right now, probably, I'm gonna guess 12 to 15 yards from it, looks like. Something like that. That's on moonlight. There's your low mode. There's your medium. Back up to high mode. But I was really surprised with the amount of light this thing puts out, to be honest. I don't know if this little old camera picking up out across there, but it looks like it on the screen. That tree line over there is about 80 yards from us. If it's picking it up on this camera right now, I can see it pretty decent with my eyes if the camera's getting it in there. Good little old light for its size, especially. I'm gonna go ahead, I just want to show a little bit of quick footage out here. Go ahead and wrap this video up. I appreciate everybody watching, and I will catch y'all next time.